We're talking tiny houses and the baffling bureaucracy surrounding them.
So at the moment, each council can choose how it interprets the Building Act, which means someone in Manawatū might be facing huge bills to get their tiny home compliant, whereas someone living in North Canterbury may not.
We wanted to get some consistent answers, so Jill went straight to the top.
Tiny homes on wheels, an area where confusion reigns.
The question is, what's a building and what's not? It's become a thorny issue as people try to work out exactly what needs building consent.
From zero? Definitely.
Well, every house has to have a building consent.
There's your answer.
Definitely.
Not too sure.
50-50 Corbett and probably no.
No, because it's portable. Either tall bowls or this. Ah, this is the tricky.
No.
No.
The tiny house community is confused too. Fairgo surveyed nearly 250 of them. Of these, 149 want a tiny home but are too worried about regulations. 52 have built without consent. 25 say they're not even sure they need it. Only 10 have got it. 6 are working on it. 1 has been ordered by their council to vacate. And only 1 has a certificate of acceptance, which Caroline is being asked to obtain.
It's a real grey area. The regulation's very silent when it comes to definitions. Councils are interpreting the rules differently.
Green MP Gareth Hughes, a big fan of the tiny house and a critic of the problems owners are facing. He says...
It's a bit of a mess, and I think that's a disappointment because it's a real opportunity, and for some, it's a great solution to the housing crisis.
So he's getting a working group together to help find solutions. Until then...
Well, I'm just hoping for a bit of pragmatism, a bit of common sense from councils. Some of the stories I've heard do sound incredibly heavy-handed. You know, we're in a housing crisis. We've got skyrocketing homelessness rates in New Zealand. We shouldn't be kicking people out on the streets. Let's just take a bit of a pause.
That would mean holding off on those notices to fix and considering proposals from the tiny house community for more straightforward and more affordable building consents.
Because most people agree that every home could do with a bit of regulation so that it's safe with good sanitation. But the Building Act was designed more for houses like this, or like this, or this, that have got foundations and were built to last at least 50 years. But not for ones like this. So why don't simple structures have simple consent processes and tests? Because otherwise the cost of consultants and engineers can add $20,000 to about a $60,000 house. And that is crazy.
So with all the different approaches from one council to the next, we thought we should go straight to the top. So we asked the Minister for Building, Jenny Salesa, for an interview. She said no, but sent a long statement, which is hard to take in on the telly.
So we've come to the Beehive to have a quiet word. She's coming. Minister Salesa, could I just have a quick word on tiny houses?
As the big guns fire up around us, it's a promising start.
I'm changing the building Act 2004.
Sounds good.
I've already asked the Ministry of Business, Innovation and Employment to give me some advice on how we move forward with tiny homes.
Still sounding good, I think. So what's the focus of the proposed changes?
Building products. At the moment, we have over 600,000 building products in New Zealand. None of it is regulated. I'm also focused on the building levy and the penalty.
So what about tiny houses?
At the moment, the building code, as well as the Building Act 2004, is adequate for building of all homes, including tiny homes.
But everyone agrees we've got a housing crisis and tiny houses could be a possible solution, except...
Compliance costs associated with the current structure, they're way beyond what they can afford.
The way that we build homes is the same for everyone. Whether it's a tiny home or a larger home, we all go through the Building Act 2004 or the Building Code. Everyone needs to comply with the Building Code.
But shouldn't there be a simpler structure?
Tens of thousands of tiny house owners think there should be. But for now, it seems that's too tiny a number for government to act.
I am beginning to sense what it must be like for those owners of tiny homes, because we didn't get an answer then, did we?
No, she kind of left the interview halfway because maybe she didn't have any answers.
Look, what can you do if you're thinking of investing in a tiny home? Well, the first thing is find out what rules your council is following and whether you have to get compliance in line with the Building Act or not.
So some homework to be done, because as they say, knowledge is power, and this is one area where both would be super useful.